All right, doggies, let's get wet!
Hey, it's Jim Zelasco here for Duck Diving Tales, the event review. It's Gonzales, Louisiana, that's right. And the sun is shining bright, although the temps are not that great. It's still way better than home, so I really can't complain. But this is the inaugural Delta DockDogs event here, the Swamp Splash at Cabela's. You know Cabela's, you go on, you come here, you go in the store, you spend money. So Cabela's must like that. I think that the dogs and everybody that's here likes this. It's a great time. You know, things are a little light, and they are a new club, and things are starting to gel together for them. So not everything's perfect, but I'm impressed. I think they've done a great job. Let's roll some footage, show you what it was all about.
That's right, it's Delta DockDogs and their very first ever competition. And it was my pleasure to be at the inaugural Delta DockDogs event, being held at the Gonzales, Louisiana Cabela's store. Off to the right of the sidewalk of a good-sized Cabela's sat the dock and pool, as well as a group of die-hard Southern DockDoggers just waiting to get the weekend rolling. Under overcast skies and chilly temperatures, Saturday morning started off looking gloomy, unless you were one of those lucky dogs that got to play fetch in the water with their master. But the clouds cleared after a few hours, giving way to sunshine and a bit of a warm-up into the mid-60s. A stiff north wind kept the pool water rippling and easy ups tied down firm, but that's about the extent of any unfavorable weather that we experienced, and it certainly wasn't going to slow down this new club from putting on a show. With a great deal of support from the Heart of Texas Dock Dogs Club, things got started on Saturday morning with an open dock practice, letting a few newbies give it a try. Soon after, the very first ever Delta Dock Dogs Big Air Wave got underway. Folks going and coming out of the store stopped sometimes for a long time to watch the competition. The cooler temps kept them at bay from the splash zones of the pools, but plenty of cell phones trying to take pictures dotted the audience. At times was pretty impressive for mostly being passers-by. Dogtown was right there next to the pool, and you had your choice of being on the grass or concrete. Most chose the concrete and left the grass for the dogs to do their business. Speaking of doing your business, humans needed to go into the store to do theirs, which was a bit of a walk, but the store's facilities are great. Besides, it was always another reason to go look at some more items to add to your wish list from Cabela's. Parking was right there also, front row if you were there early enough, and of course it was free. The waves moved on only a little off schedule at times. Taking a hint from the Texas Dock Dogs Club, this group also scheduled a speed retreat for each day and ran all three disciplines on Saturday. I caught up with the club's president, Chad Miller, to talk with him a bit about the club and this event.
Hey, I found Chad Miller. Chad is the president of Delta Dock Dogs, and he helped bring this out here to Cabela's at the Swamp Splash this wonderful weekend. Chad, how are you, and what do you think of this event?
Thanks a bunch for coming anyway, Jim.
It's my pleasure.
Glad to have some northerners come down and have some fun with us. It's turning out pretty good. We got a lot of newcomers today that came out yesterday, seen it, and they decided to come to test everything out. A lot of first-time jumpers. And they're doing pretty well.
That's fantastic. So we're out here getting a lot of people addicted to dock dogs. That's not hard to do, is it? You just set up a pool and a dock and they seem to come, right?
Yeah. We got a few that, it's taking a little time to get them going, but they're enjoying it.
So tell me a quick story. You were telling me earlier about how you got involved in dock dogs. You were just looking for something to do with your dog, right?
Yeah, there wasn't much, you know, in South Louisiana. Traveling can be a pain sometimes nowadays. We do go to Heart of Texas as events as much as possible, but we need something a little more local to bring everybody together.
Right.
And I'm hoping that's what happens, and I think it is. You know,
yeah.
We're pulling in from New Orleans area, although Delta is out of Houma, Louisiana. We're still catering to everybody along the Gulf Coast, okay, from Texas east.
Okay.
So it works out pretty well.
Well, great. That's fantastic. And I smell the jambalaya cooking over there. It's making me hungry.
Yeah,
already.
That's some good stuff. Can't wait till lunch.
We can turn up the thermostat just a little bit, but as I was saying earlier in the opener, I can't complain really because there's a hurricane, or what's going to be left of it, running up the coast and can actually be coming to my house, what's left of it. So I won't complain. But
today turned out a little better than yesterday.
Yeah.
It was overcast most mornings. But the sun came up first thing this morning. A little breezy.
Yes.
We can deal with it.
I'll take this for the end of October. Thank you, Chad.
Thank you, Jim. Appreciate it. Thanks, everybody, for coming. Doc Dogs for allowing us to do this, too.
Sunday brought more sunshine, but still cooler temps. Nevertheless, the finals got underway and were divisional style. No cash prizes for this young club, but nice ribbons and prize bags were given, as well as a t-shirt commemorating the event. To sum it all up, I'd say that they had a very successful first event. I'm pretty sure that they would not have been able to pull it off without the Texas club, and Chad gratefully acknowledged that several times. As their membership grows, I'm sure that the additional help will come. This event in itself should serve to further promote both the sport of Dock Dogs and Delta Dock Dogs in that area. Amongst a few other adjoining activities that were set up at this store in conjunction with Delta Dock Dogs was NOLA Lab Rescue. I've actually done some transports of rescues related to this group, and it was great to see them working there to get a few dogs adopted that weekend right by the competition. In fact, I was there when they announced that one of the dogs just found a new forever home. How exciting of a moment. I also saw a few other rescues related to that group while at this event. I began to learn more about Delta Dock Dogs and Heart of Texas Dock Dogs' connection with the rescues, and as I learned and observed, I grew to further admire their work and dedication to such a wonderful cause. Seeing a couple of those dogs' faces, such good-looking dogs now. It's so hard to look at them and believe that they had no home. I just want to say thank you for the work that those people do, and thank you to all those involved in animal rescue, particularly dogs. And to those of you looking for a dog, please consider rescuing. You would not believe how many great dogs are out there just waiting. Don't make them wait too long. Well, that wraps up another episode of Dock Diving Tales. I'm glad you're watching, and thank you for doing so. Next, it's the big one, the Dock Dogs World Championship from Dubuque, Iowa. They take place in just 2 weeks, November 15th through the 18th. That's where I'll be. I'm so looking forward to seeing many friends again. I can't wait. I hope that you've signed up for the banquet there, because going there and not going to the banquet, I think, would be a huge mistake. You're going to miss a lot of information, a lot of fun, and get to see a lot of your friends and possibly yourself, getting some recognition for all your accomplishments in Dock Dogs. Until then, if you're traveling, please be safe, and also keep it safe for the best thing you'll ever bring or take home from the Dock Dogs World Championships, your dog.